Hey everyone, happy Monday, May 25th, also Memorial Day, and welcome back to another Five Good Things. I know I said I was going to be gone for a week, and it's now been two, but hey, sometimes you need to take a break and rest a little bit to go a little farther. As we move forward and as lockdown continues to lift, I'm going to probably be cutting back on some of these episodes. For one, I'm going to be returning to work and not teleworking as much, so I won't have as much free time in my schedule to film these, but I'm going to keep filming them to some extent, probably one or two a week, just because I don't know if you've noticed, but there is still a lot of negativity out there. So I'm going to throw some good things out into the world for you guys to look at and enjoy. And with that, we'll get started. So as of 6:30 p.m. today, there are 2,355,141 people who have recovered globally from COVID-19. Here are your five good things for today. First step, forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. The Concord Baptist Church in Brooklyn, New York, took that portion of the Lord's Prayer seriously and paid $35,000 to buy $4 million worth of medical debt for 4,500 people through RIP Medical Debt Relief, and then forgave everything. The recipients will start receiving letters in the mail informing them that they are now debt-free. Reverend Gary V. Simpson, who leads the church, said, "This is not forgiveness of a debt. This is freedom from a debt. This isn't the first amazing Christian act of generosity the church has done. The church has made annual donations to social causes since 1988, starting with a $1 million seed fund. Even before COVID-19 struck, the church had decided that this was the year to focus on medical debt." Reverend Simpson said, "This year we targeted medical debt because we wanted to show the need for affordable healthcare. Healthcare debt can be a secondary trauma on top of coronavirus or any other ailment itself." And speaking of debts being repaid, there's a 175-year-old debt that is in the process of being repaid. From 1846 through 1851, the Irish potato famine, also known as the Great Hunger or the Great Famine, killed about 1 million people in Ireland. The Choctaw Nation, a Native American group in the United States, raised then $170, which actually translates to about $5,350 today, for a relief fund which sent food and clothing from the United States to Ireland during the Great Famine. At the time the money was sent, the Choctaw Nation was still suffering from the toll of the Trail of Tears that it had taken on its population. Nearly a quarter of the Choctaw tribe was wiped out when they were forced to relocate and trek 600 miles from areas in the southeast to territory west of the Mississippi. Now the Irish are returning the favor to the peoples of the Navajo and Hopi tribes who have been extraordinarily and disproportionately impacted by the COVID-19 outbreak. Of an international GoFundMe campaign that's raised about $3.1 million, and that actually was as of May 8th, so this is probably even more by now, the Irish alone, of that $3.1 million, the Irish alone raised 20% of the funds themselves. Comments from Irish donors included, "At Ireland's time of need during the Great Hunger of the 1840s, Native American people donated to the famine relief effort, even though they themselves were still living in hardship. Their generosity will never be forgotten." Another donor wrote, "When Ireland was in need, you understood what solidarity really looked like." And finally, another wrote, "We're now showing solidarity with the oppressed as well as paying it forward with thanks and love from Ireland for the aid we received during the Great Famine. A huge debt of gratitude to the Choctaw Nation, and Ireland never forgets." Next up, that's now Sir Thomas More to you. Captain Tom update. If you haven't noticed from some of my previous videos, I've basically started a Captain Tom More fan club. We're in the process of getting shirts. So anyway, well, it turns out the amazing chap is now Sir Thomas More. Captain Tom More, the British World War II veteran, has raised $39 million to support the NHS and is now being awarded a knighthood by Her Majesty the Queen in recognition of how he has inspired Britons and the world alike. Captain Tom lives in Bedfordshire, England, and the local Bedfordshire government renamed a section of the forest for him, Captain Tom More's Spinney. And this one, well, I don't think you need a whole lot of intro to this. Just watch and enjoy. Power, you're supplying. It's electrifying. You better shape up. Cause I need a man. You know, sometimes a girl's just gotta dance, or two full-grown men just gotta dance. You do you, boo. All right, next up, Dad, How Do I? Last but not least, Robert Kenny grew up without a father. He recalled his father telling his mother, "You're gonna have to figure out what to do with these kids, otherwise I'm putting them in foster homes." Kenny, now a father, used this intensely negative and abusive experience and turned it into something that could help kids in similar situations. Introducing the Dad How Do I channel on YouTube. Kenny has taken to filming YouTube videos on how to fix various fixtures around your house or your car, how to tie a tie, how to find a stud, check your oil, hang a shelf, and most importantly, how to be good to yourself. And videos of him saying how proud he is of the viewer. Now that truly is something good. Now those are the five things for Monday, May 25th, but given it's Memorial Day, here's a sixth. I didn't want to end this episode without acknowledging the importance of today. Memorial Day and Veterans Day are two different days, and sometimes people get these confused. So Veterans Day is when you thank someone who's serving or has served in the military. Memorial Day is specifically for those who have served in the military and lost their lives, either in active duty combat, after they've come back, or have just passed away over time. So it's to remember the lives of veterans who have been lost or military members who have been lost. So I just wanted to honor them and say we remember that their sacrifice, and honestly, we owe them so much more than just a thank you. So here's a moment to honor veterans and those who have passed for Memorial Day. And those are your five, well, six good things of today. So that's it for today. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you again probably at the end of this week. I hope you guys have a good rest of your week. And remember, be kind to yourselves, be kind to other people, and hang in there because we're in this together for good. I'll see you guys at the end of this week for another five good things.